I expected to enjoy Extraction 2 because I really liked the first one. However, I did not expect to enjoy Extraction 2 anywhere near as much as I did. The first Extraction film was honestly a pretty dull story with weak characters that was carried by moments of intense and interesting action sequences. There's one sequence in the first film where the action continues for like 11 minutes and it's shot as a continuing sequence, which was just awesome. However, compared to films like John Wick, Extraction 1 was a little disappointing for me personally. A good film with great action, but none of the characters were memorable, and so I didn't really care all that much. I didn't care about Tyler Rake anywhere near as much as I did for the likes of John Wick, Kane, or even Hutch from Nobody. And Extraction 2 recognised that. There was a lot of time allotted to developing Tyler Rake in this film. It's definitely not the greatest character development you'll ever see. This is still first and foremost all about the action sequences, which are magnificent here. The action in this film is better than the action in the first, but I do like that Rake is given some backstory and there are a few extra layers to him this time around, which is great for Chris Hemsworth. I think he really needed this film after the wacky zaniness of Thor: Love and Thunder, and I'm glad that he got to have the opportunity to delve into a more serious, more physical character. It's very clear that he's enjoying this role, and I think after this film, he cemented this character as one of the action hero greats. John Wick would still probably kill him though. Tyler Rake isn't the only character that receives some much needed development in this sequel. Nick returns from the first film too, and this film asks a lot more from her than the first one. She's present for the vast majority of the film and plays a large part in most of the action sequences. It's possible I've forgotten what their relationship was in the first film, but this film does a tremendous job of showing the importance of Rake to Nick and Nick to Rake. To me, there was this underlying romantic connection, and even if I'm off on that one, Chris Hemsworth and Goldshifter Varahani, I'm sorry, I probably mispronounced that, have great chemistry and bounce off each other very well. If Chris Hemsworth's Tyler Rake is integral to the Extraction franchise, then this film proves that Nick is too, and I'm glad that the ending of the film realised that. I said earlier that the action was better in this film than the last one, and that is certainly true. The action was the core strength of the first film, so I'm glad that along with everything else in this sequel, it received a substantial improvement. Director Sam Hargrave clearly understands how to shoot action. We're not constantly glued to characters' faces, we're further out, able to see all the beautiful choreography on display. The action is intense and raw. Our heroes may be quickly dispatching people left, right and centre, but that doesn't mean the villains aren't getting a few hits in either. Tyler Rake takes a lot of damage in this film, not as much as the first, otherwise he would actually die for certain this time, but the enemies he faces are no pushovers. This also extends to both Nick and Yaz, Nick's brother. Yaz in particular takes quite the beating in this film, which was sad because he was a really fun character here. I also like that Nick takes a lot of damage here too. It really shows how cool and badass she is, that she's getting thrown around by people much stronger than her, yet she's still able to take them down. I also greatly enjoyed how this film utilises humour. For the most part, there isn't much humour here, and the film is rightly focused a lot more on being serious and delighting with action sequences. However, this film weaves humour into the action. I don't mean that Tyler sees a guy pull out a knife and then says, "That's not a knife," and then pulls out his own much larger knife. No, the humour here is similar to what you would get in John Wick. Like in John Wick 4 when he killed his way up a staircase, only to get pushed the entire way down the staircase once he reached the top. There's just moments of dark humour in this film. Every now and then, Tyler kills a guy in such a surprisingly extravagant way, or just a really brutal one that you can't help but chuckle. This is a great film and I'm very much looking forward to the inevitable Extraction 3. That said, there were some issues here that I can't ignore. First of all, the villain sucks. This has nothing to do with the acting, it's just that the character is a real nothing burger. There's nothing compelling about him, there's no understandable or sympathetic motivation, there's no "this guy is so evil that I love to hate him," he's not even weird or creepy. He's just a really bland antagonist and I doubt that anyone will remember him once the credits are over. Also, whilst the first half of the film plays out in a way that makes total sense, the second half only occurs because one of the characters in this film is a complete idiot. I'm of course talking about the son character. You just knew this guy was going to cause issues and pretty much everything bad that happens in this film is because of him. I'm not saying I wanted him to die or anything, it's just that I wouldn't have minded if he lost an eye or something along the way. You know, build some character for the lad. Consequences of one's own actions. For the sequel, I kinda want to see a larger cast of goodies, because in this film, there were only 3 characters that were ever in any danger of actually dying. So whilst it did allow those 3 characters to shine, it also meant that I was only ever really concerned about one of them being in the danger zone, as the other 2 always felt safe to me. Extraction 2 won't challenge your beliefs, it won't cause you to rethink your whole life, you're not going to walk away from this film looking at the whole world differently. Instead, you're going to be thoroughly entertained as Chris Hemsworth murders his way through a seemingly never-ending group of people. Extraction 2 is a fantastic action movie, and with this and films like John Wick and Nobody, it seems like we're getting a resurgence of genuinely great action films. I hope you all enjoyed Extraction 2. Let me know in the comments what other great modern action films there are, because I seem to really enjoy a good slice of action. Anyway, thanks for watching, see you next time, bye bye.